We have prepared a detailed step-by-step tutorial on how to use Microsoft Paint 3D brushes and basic drawing tools for beginners and those who want to learn. To get the most out of this training, following this content and our previous and subsequent or other related trainings that we publish in series will help you understand and achieve much more. The brushes section on the tools bar is usually selected when the program is first opened. If a different set of tools is open, the brushes section is a set of tools ready to use at any time with a single click. The brush and drawing tools with their iconic symbols are actually quite intuitive. When you hover over them for detailed information, the name or properties of the respective brush or drawing tool are displayed right above it with a small info box. For example, the eyedropper tool helps us to select a color swatch from anywhere in our workspace, and when we wait a bit on the eyedropper, the information box shows us this and detailed information. We'll explore the details and properties of each brush tool separately. But first, let's take a quick look at the reflection of each brush or drawing tool on the canvas. To give you a quick preview, we scribble randomly on the canvas, first with the mouse and then with the drawing tablet pen. The pencil and crayon drawing tablet are pressure sensitive, while other brushes and drawing tools are not. We created a backup record of this work on the desktop, where we quickly demonstrated the first examples. To quickly clean the canvas, we selected the entire canvas with the Ctrl and A key combination and then deleted it with the Delete key from the keyboard to completely clean our canvas. Almost all brushes and pencils have a thickness adjustment. For the first example, we quickly draw lines of various thicknesses with a marker on the canvas to show the lines. From 1 to 100 pixels, we can change the thickness of the marker pen. The thickness setting is right on the side panel on an adjustment bar. Another way to change the thickness is to enter a numerical value in the relevant box numerically and change it. Another important adjustment section of the marker pen is the transparency adjustment, which is located just below the thickness adjustment and is used in a very similar way. The transparency setting varies in percentages. If 100% is opaque, the transparency will gradually become transparent for all values less than 100%. Just for an interesting example, with the transparency setting selected on the keyboard, we will gradually increase the transparency properties. From 0 to 100 opacity. With the arrow keys on the keyboard, while continuing to draw on the canvas with the drawing tablet stylus. As you can see, even while drawing, we can simultaneously increase or decrease settings such as transparency and thickness with the arrow keys on the keyboard if selected. After the marker pen sample, we take a backup recording of the canvas and clean the canvas completely as we did before. In the second row is a very interesting pen, a calligraphy pen, which reflects the flow of ink on the canvas depending on the speed at which you use it. Similar to its real-life counterpart, it gives a denser and thicker flow of ink and thickness where you hold it or use it slowly, and a thinner flow where you apply it quickly. With this pen, you can try a lot of things in beautiful writing, and it will help you create interesting works in drawing. Similar to a marker pen, it has a thickness and transparency setting. Except that the thickness setting is between a minimum of 8 pixels and 40 pixels. After the calligraphy pen, we come to the most interesting brush, the oil paint brush. Whether it's a successful tool or not is up for debate, but this oil paint brush is either very strange or a reality unique to paint 3D. And if it's not really weird, then it must be a joke, or it could just be a piece of modern art. Sometimes we wonder if we can make a sweater pattern with this brush. The oil paint brush offers a real-life light concealer painting function that you can use opaque with a thickness value of just 10 to 100 pixels, so no direct transparency setting is used. While we can't exactly call this mess of pixels a brushstroke created from an oil paint brush, perhaps this fluffy, illusory effect could be used to simulate textures like tree bark. Some of you may still be thinking of knitting a sweater with it. It could even help us create different textures and patterns with other brushes and tools. Or perhaps more surprisingly, it could be used to design an object with gold inlay. In fourth place is the watercolor brush. We can say that the watercolor brush is closer to reality than the oil paint brush. At least it seems more successful. We use random brush strokes and lines on the canvas to test different color thickness and transparency settings. The watercolor brush has a thickness adjustment from 5 pixels up to 200 pixels and also a transparency adjustment. Even with just this brush, you can create amazing paintings, but you are limited by your patience, talent, and skills. We try the same drawing tricks here as we did with the other drawing tools. In fifth place is the pixel pen, which can be thought of as a ball pen. But it has no anti-aliasing and offers a very straight and consistent line. Since there is no anti-aliasing feature, it gives a pixel-by-pixel hard and rough look, as the name suggests. But it is necessary for some works, especially for works such as pixel art. Similar to a marker pen, it has thickness and transparency settings and can vary in thickness from 1 to 100. Our next drawing tool is the natural pen or pencil, which is close to a real-life pencil and is also pressure-sensitive. The rotation angle is fixed and there are also thickness and transparency settings in the range of 5 to 10 pixels. All drawing tools allow you to work with any color you wish. You just need to choose a color below or take a color sample with the eyedropper tool from the place you want in the workspace. Actually, there is an eraser tool in the seventh row, but we will continue with the next example and then go into the details of the eraser tool. The crayon tool is familiar to almost everyone. Most people have started drawing and painting with crayons in real life. The crayon, which shows features similar to real life, is another successful tool within Paint 3D standards and among drawing tools. Thickness settings range from 10 pixels to 100 pixels, and there are also transparency settings. To demonstrate some of the capabilities of the crayon tool with random doodles, we fill a large part of the canvas with different colored crayon lines. This time, Instead of selecting and deleting all of them after taking a backup recording, we will delete them using the previous tool, the Eraser tool. And we will quickly demonstrate the general features of the Eraser tool. The Eraser tool is a tool we use for erasing on canvas and has the ability to adjust the thickness from 1 to 200 pixels. You can also create different effects and patterns in your drawings with the erasing process. The erasing direction of the Eraser tool is not just erasing. You will understand them better in more complicated examples in the future. The paint sprayer or spray can tool works similarly to real life. You can apply paint by spraying it onto the canvas. The paint sprayer tool has thickness settings from 25 pixels to 300 pixels and transparency settings. With this tool, you can create amazing graffiti lettering and many different effects. Anything you can do with spray paint. Spraying starts with a click, and as the click continues, you can spray little by little, overlapping or layer by layer, increasing the color intensity on the surface you are painting. The last tool we will introduce is the paint bucket, also known as the color filling tool. The fill with color tool is used to fill an area with the selected color. It is quite simple to use, but if you don't pay attention to the details in the settings, you can accidentally paint the entire canvas completely, unless you do it on purpose. While the fill type of the paint bucket tool provides standard use with the default color, its other different properties, such as edges and angles, are more commonly used for painting 3D objects, which we will cover in detail in future examples. With its standard features, the paint bucket tool has two main features, one of which is the tolerance values. For the tolerance value, if you select a tolerance setting of 100 in 100, it will go beyond all limits and paint the entire canvas or object completely. But if the tolerance value is less than 100 in 100, it will take some limits into account and maintain the limits of the painting coverage. For example, if we want to change the color of the inside of a drawing that is empty or filled with some kind of color, the tolerance setting must be less than 100 in 100. Otherwise, it will overflow the boundaries and may even paint the entire canvas. We continue to show this on canvas in practice. Color options include glossy, matte, metallic, etc., which may not produce very noticeable results for standard 2D painting, but make a significant difference for painting 3D objects. In the future, we will go into the painting of 3D objects in more detail, but let's start with a very short example. For example, let's show the metallic and polished metal color and other colors in practice on a simple sphere and a 3D prism or pyramid shape. We will discuss the colors and details in more depth later. We have shown the topic of brushes significantly step by step and explained it practically. This series of tutorials on our channel will teach you step by step how to use the Paint 3D editor, each covering a different topic. We will start with basic tasks and gradually move towards more complex features. Each chapter will build on the knowledge from the previous chapters so that you can learn effectively and efficiently. We will continue the series with more beautiful trainings, and we will be with you again very soon.
Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.